All right, so my name is Emmaleigh Loyer, and we're in Chicago at the Cognitive Neurology and Alzheimer's Disease Center at the Northwestern Feinberg School of Medicine. A little bit about what I do. So I'm a research assistant here at the center, and I work on two different projects. The first is called the Superaging Study, and that study is, in my opinion, very, very interesting. It works with all of our participants over the age of 80, and so a lot of them are even in their 90s, and these are people who are very actively engaged in life and actually have extraordinary memory capacity. So these are people who have a memory of someone in their 50s and 60s, so people who are 20 to 30 years their junior. So that's the first study I work on, and the second one is called the PPA study. So PPA stands for primary progressive aphasia, and it's a rare form of dementia that affects the language network. So those are the two main studies that I work on, and for both of them, I administer neuropsychological tests to the research participants. And what I really like about that is that I spend, you know, at least 6 to 9 hours with each person, getting to know them, and it's nice to be able to work with people while you're also doing science. So I grew up in Shelburne, Vermont. I really loved growing up on the East Coast, so I decided to stay in New England to go to college. I went to Bates College in Maine, where I studied neuroscience. I graduated last May and then moved out to Chicago for this. I think what initially got me so excited about science is the opportunity to have findings that can really have a positive impact on people's lives. I think it's really meaningful work, and I also love being a part of a group of people that are working towards concrete goals that can expand our knowledge of science, and also not just science, but diseases and disorders that are impacting so many people across the world. So for the PPA study, I think we're already doing some of these things, but I hope that they'll continue and actually even progress to be stronger. I really want to be able to educate people about primary progressive aphasia, because before I took some classes in college, I didn't even really know what it is. And I think that a lot of people are unaware of what PPA is. So being able to contribute to that and further people's understanding of these types of dementias, not just PPA, but other forms of dementia that we study here at the center. Eventually, you know, it would be great if we could find a cure. But there are a lot of other opportunities to help these individuals. So there's no treatment right now. So there are no medications or anything like that. We're really working on understanding what's going on and creating a comprehensive picture of what PPA is. And so it is my hope that someday we'll be able to give these types of treatments, but I guess a little bit more in the short term, at least would be more realistic, is things like speech therapy, which we do here at the center. Also, we have a lot of social workers who work with the families here. So being able to really support them is really important to me, I think. And there are also a lot of other life-enriching interventions that can help these people, both in the short term and the long term. So I think those are kind of the main goals for that study. So I really do love the job. I get excited about getting up in the morning and coming to work and having the opportunity to join the group of people who work here at the center. So I think those are some of the main reasons that I'm so interested in it. I think also I love working as a scientist in this field. It gives you a chance to really push yourself. I feel like I don't only expand my knowledge of science every day, but I also am able to, I guess, improve my critical thinking skills and ability to work with other people, communication skills and things like that. So I definitely think as a scientist, it gives you the opportunity to build your skills that can be really applicable to other situations outside of work.